We all have been talking about taking a trip like this one for years. Two couples, two bikes, and some amazing riding. We looked into a few different options. After much debate, Tyler, Heather, Jeremy, and I finally settled on Northern Italy, allowing us easy access to some of the most epic alpine passes. We rented two BMW R1200 GSs from Route Due outside of Milan. As new business owners of AltRider, Jeremy and I wanted to take full advantage of this opportunity. So of course we had to outfit the bikes with AltRider parts. The first day we headed over to Bergamo. This is a little town about 40 kilometers northeast of Milan. The next day is when the trip really began. We went up a few smaller passes, then up through Gavia Pass. This was probably the first pass where my heart was racing and the thought of serious injury or death was at the forefront of my mind. I'd like to note that the reason I ride my own bike is to avoid riding on the back with Jeremy. Both he and Tyler are very aggressive yet talented riders that like to race, even with passengers and luggage. The next pass was Stelvio Pass. At over 9,000 feet, it's the second highest pass in the Alps, and it's been a dream of Tyler's to ride this on two wheels for more than a decade. The road was finished in 1845, and the madman who designed it created 60 hairpin turns. Stelvio Pass is considered by many to be one of the most difficult and best rides in the world. Jeremy and Tyler can't help but race when on two wheels, although I doubt they'd admit this. While on this epic pass, they can proudly say they passed several sport bikes, even with the ladies and hundreds of pounds of luggage strapped to their machines. After this, we headed up to St. Moritz in Switzerland. At the end of the day, when we were relaxed, enjoying fine wine, Chateaubriand, and a rack of lamb, Tyler proclaimed this was one of the best days of his life. The next day we met up with Giovanni, an Italian photographer I've known for a number of years. We went through Maloja Pass with him and a few more passes while stopping quite often, which is typical on a photo shoot. The second half of the day was spent near Lake Como, which we've all heard about but none of us had ever been to before. It was beautiful and calm riding, around the lake that was spotted with little boats and through lakeside towns with centuries-old villas overlooking the water. Well, perfect settings and awesome mountain riding apparently were not enough for us. We wanted to get a little dirt therapy, so Giovanni called a friend to get the inside scoop about where to ride. He got the details, so we backtracked a bit, then headed up the mountain. The road continued to narrow and the pavement turned to rocks, then mostly to dirt. The view was even more beautiful and nearly surreal from high above the lake. We took some shots at the top, then headed back down to call it a day. We said goodbye to Giovanni and headed over to Lake Lugano. We ended up at a nice little hotel on an Italian piazza overlooking the lake. The trip was a lot of fun, and I know we'd all highly recommend it to other riders. It took us 5 days, but you could easily extend the trip further east towards Venice, then ride through more of the Dolomites. Or, if you're just in Milan for a couple days, you could easily do part of the route backwards and see the lakes and ride through some of the epic passes. If you want more information about this trip or need to outfit your adventure bike, look us up at AltRider.com.